Welcome everyone to Holy Grounds Open Mic. As a special treat, because we had to switch dates around after the big rainstorm we had, tonight is our workshop night, and it will be led by local El Sereno writer, Emily Fernandez. Give it up, she's in the house. Kimberly Covian. I'm so glad we're all here. It's a beautiful night. This is a beautiful space. Let's all create together.
Yeah, baby.
I'll open up with a piece. I want to open up with the piece that was published in the Heartbreak Anthology. This was a huge presentation by Zizek's writer and local poet friend Karine Madesian. Send out our shout outs to her for bringing us heartbroken women together to feel inspired and create together. And this is an awesome endeavor. We're so happy we're a part of this. So I'm going to read my poem from that. It's called Home Remedy. I never cried so much as when I was a little girl, helping my aunt chop onions in a kitchen with a broken dishwasher and an overheating fridge. As my aunt hangs a thin slab of meat on a wire strung across the stove, she says, "We have to sweat it out." "Too bloody," she scoffs at the entrails. "I couldn't find anything fresher." At the butcher shop, she knows a real man who can sweep her off her feet better than my own flesh and blood mother can raise me. "She's never home," she yells as she breaks a mouthful of teeth of garlic with her blushed, liver-spotted hands. "Why does she have to work?" She gives me one, stained from the blood on the cutting board. "Here, suck on this. It will help you stop crying." Okay, as tradition dictates, we go through the two rounds of open mic. Unless it's a really full night, we go through three, sometimes four rounds of open mic in between features. So let's start. All right, number one, no one. Number two, a ghost writer, blank person. Number three, all right, my homegirl, my sister in poetry, and above all things, fabulous, Jessica Wilson.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kimberly.
Holy ground.
This is my first time here at Holy Grounds, and this place is amazing. So beautiful, quite a gem in East LA. I love it. Thanks, and I'm happy to be here, and I'm gonna read like a couple poems, I guess. Yeah, cool. This is called The Children. We are the sons and daughters of indigenous. Oh, you didn't know? Well, it's not your fault. Don't blame your ancestors. They fought hard, believe me. Wouldn't you have fought to keep your home? Well, they fought, but the other team won. They won with their weapons and their masses, won with bullets piercing soft skin, a shower of assault upon peaceful lands. The settlers settle for the land we were born from. The conquerors kill the people, applying their own rules. Irrigation, violation, no justification. We are the sons and daughters of indigenous blood. Don't blame our ancestors who didn't understand the words, only saw the swords, the bayonets, the forces of the other army. We are all casualties of war. Let's see. I finished putting together, the NoHo Beat Manifest. Yes, I gotta read that one. Well, I live in the North Hollywood part of town. And I have an open mic there every Wednesday night. It's called Writer Wednesdays at Bob's Espresso Bar. At 7 o'clock. Anyhow, when I was inspired to start that show a couple years ago, this piece, it's a philosophy, it's not a poem, sprung from that. And it's called The NoHo Beat. Crate to feed, placate the mind. When it hurts, it's beat. When ideas so flat fail to resolve, intimidate you, your beat. A NoHo Beat is conflicted, shredded already on the inside, but still makes the attempt to run their own lives. A beat deals with it, gives salutation to the attempts people make to accommodate their dreams, fail to see potential, fail. A beat will fail but come right back up for another try to show how their lives can be masterful by their own hands. A creation etched in mold, greened bait. I'm sorry. Yeah. I have to make this a little bit bigger. Beat can be held in the corner, asked to recognize other ways around the subject. Lonely times, much, much lonely times, Mark, but it feels good. Makes life way worth living because each move they make tests perimeter fences and shows us them. They're putting up stakes, so we must be good. Makes life way worth living. I'd rather live when that happens. Being beat, so outrageous, so exasperated that no one wants to attend your wedding, your funerals, your kid's birth, baptism, and amendment. No attitude is fostered. It's always just been about acceptance. It's not learned to be mutual, it just is. As beats align themselves amongst others of the same soul tune, bongo drum harmony, set them aside from all others so drastically, it is this dedication to sink our heads, our beats. I think us brave. As we attend and play according to rules, we still press the marker further to show that boundaries are not static but move to the aggression of the shove. We balance the incongruity in the air to conduct fondness, our new extreme. Beat is proud. The NoHo Beat is proud and emerges into jazz music rolls along the ready, steady electronics of dance. I listen to it. Follow the beats. Act noble, choose noble, face the sinks in deep conflicts. Try to reach harder, man. Beat is fast enough, slow enough, jives enough, until the hips plunder down into the swell of yours. Now join the movement that makes that beat heard and dig that funky jazz. Thank you. I dig that poem. I really do. Thank you, Jessica. All right. Juan Cardenas.
One quick second.